Great. So you know how to chop up a web page design into boxes, and you've even heard advice from an experienced front-end developer. Let's take a look at another very simple example. How do you transfer this to an HTML document? And how do you change how the boxes look? Let me quickly show you how to translate the model to HTML, and then you will write it in a file that you can open in your browser. In this design, you can see that there are four boxes. We have one over the title, another over this content, and then two more boxes inside of this larger box. One around the image, and another around the text. So let's not worry about how these boxes look or what's inside of them. And let's not worry that I haven't actually perfectly aligned the top of this box with that one. It's driving me crazy, but we don't have to worry about it right now. Now you can define this type of box with a div tag. We'll write this code using Sublime Text, and we suggest that you use either this code editor or something similar. Now we define boxes with div tags. So let's go ahead and create tags for each of our boxes. First, we'll start with the title box and start typing div. Now, this is the really nice thing of using a code editor like Sublime Text. It automatically is guessing what we might use. So we do know we want it to be a div. We can click tab, and now we have the completed HTML tags, an opening tag and a closing tag. Next, we have another box for the content, which requires another div tag. And now within this box, we have two more boxes. So we'll hit another line. So now we have four div tags for our four boxes. Now let's add some placeholder content so that we remember which boxes each of our tags refer to. So our first one is for our title, which is my app. And then we have our image and our text. Now that's great, but how do you apply style to them? The boxes are of different sizes and they're in different locations, and you need to somehow mark them so that you can easily apply style later. Now the best way to do this is to give each element a class attribute. Now you can think of these class attributes as labels on boxes, something that reminds you of what's inside of them. For example, when you move, you might give a box a label to let the movers know where it might go. For example, master bedroom or kitchen. Now, boxes can also have several labels, and the same applies to HTML tags. They can belong to multiple classes. Now, back to our moving example, you might want to say the items that go to the kitchen are also fragile, so you might add handle with care.
It's a good idea to have class names that make sense, so that you understand what the purpose of the box is just by glancing at the code. For example, while you could just give the divs class names like box1, box2, etc., it's not really informative. I mean, will you really remember that you called this title box box1? Probably not. What would make more sense is to name the top div title and then the bottom big div app. Then the div that contains the application image screenshot and the text one description. Excellent. We now have the general structure of the page down, so now it's your turn to save this in a file and see how it looks in the browser. Instructions for doing so follow.